Napunta dito.
So sir, dinidenay niyo na kinalaman niyo?
Wala talaga kasi security nga lang ako. Dalawa kami nung nere, security lang kami. Tapos ay bigla lang kami.
Sir, dami pa sir, kilala mo siya, no?
On that day, during this incident.
Never pa kayo sa nag-security bago na
kaya yung cable
pa rin.
First time.
So, pero meron silang eyewitness identifying you, aside from abducting the victims, is inakos mo rin daw yung mga witness na
yun. Wala sila, pero ito mayroon akong counter-affidavit.
Sir, nasan kayo nung panahon na nangyari yung krimen? Kung matatandaan mo?
Punta kami ng Liberia, sa Africa.
At that time, nasa ibang bansa kayo?
Nagpa-process na kami, nagpa-process na kami.
Pero nandito pa kayo nung panahon na ano?
Pero ang hindi ako nagtatrabaho sa kay Central Bank.
Saan ka that
time? Saan nga? Kasi nag-aayos kami ng papers pa.
Nasaan po ba kayo sa Bulacan dati?
Very cardinal rule kasi sa evidence that alibi is the weakest defense, especially if there is a positive categorical identification by an eyewitness. So the jurisprudence has been consistent to that effect that an alibi is very incredulous in the face of a positive identification by an eyewitness. So these records, though we did not admit as to its veracity, di ba, last time, assuming for the sake of argument, which they are not, assuming for the sake of argument that they are all true, it doesn't mean that he could not be involved. Because precisely, these operations are covert. They are not covered by paperwork. Of course, how could you imagine an operation to kill or abduct somebody to be covered by paperwork? That's stupid, no? Mm-hmm. So this does not hold the water at all. So on both grounds, alibi is very weak. Then on the second ground, when General Palparan said that he is for sure that Staff Sergeant Osorio was not involved, then that raises a lot of questions. Why? Does he know everybody who was involved in the operations? Diba? That raises a what we call a negative pregnant or a implication that, he knows everybody was involved in the operations. But on the other hand, because of the positive identification, no matter what General Palparan says, then it is very clear that Staff Sergeant Osorio was involved. Because there were 15 in the team that participated in the operation. Seven went inside the houses, eight was in the vicinity. At least insofar as Staff Sergeant Osorio is concerned. No?
Is that enough?
That's enough because clear, categorical, and credible identification, if that is not rebutted credibly, then that stays. Somebody can be convicted on the mere basis of one positive eyewitness, if that remains credible. Here in the preliminary investigation, not even talking about proof beyond reasonable doubt yet. That is for the courts to decide. We're only talking about probable cause. The question is there enough evidence at this point to bring charges against these people? And I think that is more than enough.
Are the witnesses being protected?
Yeah, I think the relatives and the organizations are creative enough and are also very careful to take care of the witnesses.